In Rwanda, a California-based startup called Zipline is pioneering a new use for drones, delivering urgently needed blood to hospitals. Rwanda's roads wind over rough and hilly terrain, but this Zipline drone, seen here being prepared for launch, can cut delivery times from hours to minutes.
Hello, my name is Israel, and welcome to Zipline's distribution center here in Muhanga in Rwanda. This is the first distribution center to do blood and medical products delivery to over more than 20 health facilities across the country, and we are the first to do it in the world on a national scale. What you see here is our operation area in on our distribution center, and we currently serve 18 hospitals across the country, and we deliver them blood. We do between 20 and 30 deliveries a day. So we have a launcher here, which pretty much catapults the drone from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour. These are our zips, and we call them zips here in Zipline. And what you can see are the bodies, and they are made by line replaceable units, where we have the bodies, the wings, and the batteries on this side. And these are smart chargers for the batteries. They both interact with our software, but also with our power system on the batteries themselves. On that side is the fulfillment area, where we receive and process orders for the facilities that we serve. They pretty much place orders using the easiest way for them. It's either an online portal, SMS, or over WhatsApp, or they can just call in and place their orders. And when we receive an order, it's packaged in there. We receive it from that window. We put it on a zip, and within less than 10 minutes, it's on the launcher and ready to go. And it flies between 15 to 30 minutes to reach the farthest hospital and comes back immediately here on our base.
We use this package to pack our product. It has this parachute that helps the package to land smoothly whenever it is dropped from the plane, and it has again this plastic air inset that helps the protection of our blood units. So here we have plenty of our blood products. So they are requesting red blood cells, O positive adult units. And then I have to put the wrapped unit into the box. It is done. Then I hand this package to the flight operators.
Zipline designed its drones to use modular wings and fuselages that can be easily swapped if a piece gets damaged. After loading the battery and blood payload, staff move the drone to the catapult. After confirming the drone's flight plan with the Rwanda Civil Aviation Authority, the supercapacitor-powered, 13-meter-long electric catapult launches the drone to 100 kilometers per hour in half of a second, on its way to a cruising altitude of 120 meters. Look up. A Zipline drone is dropping its blood cargo by parachute at a hospital in the small town of Kanazi. It's a bone-jarring hour drive to the hospital from Zipline's distribution center, but the drone made the trip in just 14 minutes.
The recovery system that we use is pretty much to be able to abruptly stop the trajectory of the zip when it's flying in on a flight route. And we use a wire that's between two carbon fibers poles. And when the zip is inbound, the wires will stop its trajectory using a tail hook that's on the zip. It's about 3 centimeters of precision.
Staff disassemble the drone and start preparing for the next flight. Zipline recently opened its second fulfillment center in Rwanda and has extended its contract with the Rwandan government to begin delivering medicines and vaccines to small health clinics. The company is also spreading its wings to other African nations and has just started delivering blood and medicines in Ghana. Back in the United States, the company is currently working on a pilot project delivering medical supplies in North Carolina. If Zipline can prove that its drone delivery service works worldwide, packages of blood may soon be dropping from the sky at a hospital near you.